Oh, hello, dears. I was just noticing that the calla lilies are in bloom again. Such a strange flower. Today we're doing another special request. Today's story is The Knight Who Was Afraid of the Dark. I hope you enjoy it. Let's get started, shall we? Once long ago, in a time known as the Dark Ages, there lived a bold and much loved knight. He was called Sir Fred. He drove monsters out of the moat. He chased the dishonest merchants out of town and saved the fair Lady Wendelin from a hideous ten-headed dragon. There was only one crack in Sir Fred's armor. Sir Fred was afraid, knee-bumping, heart-thumping afraid of the dark. He was afraid of the dark of the moon, the dark at the top of the steep stone stairs, the dark at the bottom of the big brass bed, and of dark between the head hole and the armhole when he put on his armor. Because he was afraid, Sir Fred kept his bedchamber bright with candles. He kept a bottle of fireflies on his night table and slept with his pet electric eel, whom he took with him if and when he had to get up to go to the bathroom. Of course, we don't generally talk about things like that. It is not genteel. But there he is. Sir Fred was also afraid of being found out. Indeed, there was one who suspected. That one was the castle bully, Melvin the Mift. Melvin the Mift couldn't stand Sir Fred because he was better loved, especially by Lady Wendelin. Melvin stalked the castle corridors, sneaking and peeking and trying to find the crack in Sir Fred's armor. Melvin the Mift observed that Sir Fred did all his brave deeds in broad daylight. All the other knights liked the cover of darkness. He also saw that Sir Fred was the only knight who did not cower under the round table during thunder and lightning storms. Indeed, the bolder the bolt, the better. Moreover, he observed that Sir Fred only met Lady Wendelin on nights when the moon was full, which is why they seldom saw each other and why Lady Wendelin began to wonder if she was truly Sir Fred's true love. Things came to a head one dark day when Melvin the Mift sneaked up and peeked at a letter Lady Wendelin was reading. "If your true love truly wanted to see you," Melvin the Mift whispered, "he would make up silly excuses not to." Ah, true love. Oh, sorry, I was just reminiscing about a little trip to Philadelphia one time. Forgive me. "Wicked good point," Lady Wendelin said, tossing her curls and stamping her foot. That afternoon, Lady Wendelin embroidered a banner and hung it out the window. Let's read it together, shall we? "Meet me at the fountain at midnight, or never see me again. Love? Lady Wendelin." Can you see that banner right there? Reminds me of another story, but that's for later. Sir Fred saw the banner and sank into deep despair. The evening sky was exceedingly dark and the moon was thin as a mouse's whisker. Sir Fred pummeled his pillow and hemmed and hawed. "Oh, woe, shall I stay or shall I go? If I don't go, I will lose my lady love because she will think I don't love her. If I do go, I will lose my lady love because she will think I am scared of the dark, which I am." In the end, Sir Fred went. His fear was big, but so was his love. He went armed with a fistful of fireflies, a glowworm-studded shield, and his faithful electric eel wound round his arm. Look at that. That is one way to prepare for battle. Most impressive. Lady Wendelin was waiting by the fountain with her eyes tightly closed. At the stroke of midnight, she opened them and shrieked, "Eek!" As she shrieked, she grabbed Sir Fred's hands, released the fireflies, flung the shields to the ground, and tweaked the electric eel's taillight, leaving Sir Fred terrified in total darkness. "Eek! Get off my true love!" Lady Wendelin shrieked again as she flicked the last lingering firefly from Sir Fred's sleeve. "To tell the truth," she said then, "I'm terrified of bugs and all slithery things that creep and crawl." Sir Fred then did his bravest deed. He told Lady Wendelin the truth about himself. "I am," he admitted, "afraid of the dark. Knee-bumping, heart-thumping afraid of the dark." "Then you are even braver than I thought," Lady Wendelin said, flinging her arms round Sir Fred, "because you met me anyway." "And you are brave as well as beautiful," Sir Fred said with a kiss, "because you tried to protect me." Well, of course she did, because she's a brave and bold girl. We like that. She'll probably even end up wearing trousers at some point. Melvin the Mift was still sneaking and peeking around. He saw the loving scene and snorted. How sickening. Then he stamped his feet and stalked off forever. Nobody saw him leave. Lady Wendelin was too busy patting Sir Fred's electric eel and saying, "He's not as scary as I thought." Meanwhile, Sir Fred was clutching his true love and telling her, "The dark's not so scary either, with someone." And there they are, my darlings. I'll also show you this picture on the bottom, though I'm not quite sure what exactly it has to do with the story. Let's see. Yes, I've got nothing. I'm so sorry. All right. Well, thank you so much for tuning in today. We hope you enjoyed our little story time, and we'll see you next time. I have to go now because I have to wash my hair. Goodbye.